Good morning, students. Now we are going to discussing about system of non-homogeneous linear equations in two variables x comma y. Already we know about these linear equations in 10th class only. So, but once again you recall this. See, let the equation be some a1x plus b1y is equal to c1, a2x plus b2y is equal to c2. What is the meaning of non-homogeneous means? So, in the equation, if every term has the same degree, then those equations are called homogeneous equations. If every term has a degree, that means they have the different degrees, then those equations are called non-homogeneous equation. For suppose this degree is 1, this degree is 1, constant degree is 0. So it is non-homogeneous. Okay. Next, types of lines. If the given lines may be intersecting, parallel or coincident, if they are intersecting like this, then the condition is a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, same 10th class condition. The number of solution, this is only the solution, next one only. So if they are parallel lines, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2, number of solution, they never be intersect, so zero solutions. Coincident lines, so one is on the other one. So, the condition is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. That means these are the a1, a2, b1, b2, c1, c2. Okay. Then, common solutions are infinite, we can see. So, all these are nothing but points only. Okay. So, all these are common points. All common points are nothing but solutions. So, infinitely many solutions. Next, one question based on this one. If k plus 1 into x plus 8y is equal to 4k and kx plus k plus 3 into y is equal to 3k minus 1 has infinite number of solutions, then the value of k is infinite number of solutions means a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. Just to follow that one. So, if you take these two equalities, so cross multiplication k square plus 3k plus k plus 3. So, totally we have k square plus 4k plus 3 for multiplication, and it is 8k. So, transpose this side, k square plus 4k minus 8k, that is minus 4k plus 3 is equal to 0. So, factorization, so 1 3s are 3. So, k square minus k minus 3k plus 3 is equal to 0. So, take common k minus 1 minus 3 into k minus 1 is equal to 0. So, k, if you take k minus 1 common, we have k minus 3 is equal to 0. Product of two numbers is equal to 0 means either first number 0 or second number 0. Therefore, k is equal to 3, k is equal to 1. Similarly, if you use these two, what you get? 3 8s are 24k minus 8 is equal to 4k square plus 3 4s are 12k. This is 4k square. So, plus 24k transpose this side minus 24k, 12k minus 24 minus 12k minus 8 transpose this side plus 8 is equal to 0. So, we have here 4 is common for every term. So, after taking 4 common outside and transpose to right side, that becomes to 0 only. So, we have k square minus 3k plus 2 is equal to 0. So, again factorization, 1 2s are 2, k square minus 2k minus k plus 2 is equal to 0. So, k into k minus 2 minus 1 into k minus 2 is equal to 0. So, we have k minus 1 into k minus 2 is equal to 0, k is equal to 1 or k is equal to 2. So, the common value of for these two, because these two should be hold, these two should be hold. So, both will be hold means what we have common, that one only we have to take. So, here common is k is equal to 1. The common value of them is 1. So, k is equal to 1. Next question. Consider alpha x plus 2y is equal to lambda, 3x minus 2y is equal to mu, then number of solutions is 0, then alpha is equal to minus 3 and lambda mu is not equal to 0. These are the options for this question. Okay, unique solution, then alpha is not equal to minus 3, infinite number of solution, then alpha is equal to minus 3 and lambda plus mu is equal to 0. Once you see this question, first one, number of solutions is 0. Number of solutions is 0 when you get if they are parallel lines. So, parallel lines means a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. So, alpha by 3 is equal to 2 by minus 2 is not equal to lambda by mu. So, equation these two if you equate, minus 2 alpha is equal to 6, alpha is equal to minus 6 by 2. So, alpha is equal to minus 3. And if you take this one, 2 by minus 2, that is minus 1. Minus 1 is not equal to lambda by mu. That means minus mu is not equal to lambda. Minus put transpose this side, lambda plus mu is not equal to 0. Okay, see here, the first option is correct or not? 100% correct. Next, second question. Unique solution, then alpha is equal to dash. So, if you understand, so the number of solutions of is 0, then alpha is equal to dash and lambda plus mu is equal to dash. These are the options. If you take in this same equations, second question, unique solution, then alpha is equal to how much? Unique solution means a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. So, minus 2 alpha or 2 get cancelled, minus 1 alpha is not equal to minus 3. So, we got minus 3. Next one. The infinite number of solutions. Infinite a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. So alpha by 3 is equal to 2 by minus 2 is equal to lambda by mu. So this is minus 1, 3 transpose the side, alpha is equal to minus 3. And these two are also equal, lambda by mu is equal to minus 1. So minus mu transpose this side, lambda plus mu is equal to 0. So we have alpha is equal to minus 3, lambda plus mu is equal to 0. So let's say one question. In based on these two equations, we have three questions. Next one. System of non-homogeneous linear equations in three variables x, y, and z. So let the non-homogeneous equation three variables be a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to d1. Here x, y, z are variables, a1, b1, c1, d1 are constants. Similarly, a2x plus b2y plus c2z plus d is equal to d2, a3x plus b3y plus c3z is equal to d3. So, actually, whenever we have three non-homogeneous equations in three variables, here a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3 are the coefficients of x, y, z. If you write these coefficients in the one matrix as a1, b1, c1 as first row, first equation corresponding coefficients write in first row and second row and third row respectively, a2, b2, c2, second row, a3, b3, c3, third row. And this is nothing but if you write x, y, z in column matrix and this d1, d2, d3 is also one of the column matrix, then this let us consider this matrix B, let us say some A, this matrix variable matrix, let us say X, constant matrix, let us say B. Then this A X is equal to B is nothing but the matrix form of the given equations. See, once you observe here, cross actually how to multiply these two matrices, A1X plus B1Y plus C1Z, A2X plus B2Y plus C2Z, a3x plus b3y plus c3z. So a1x plus b1y plus c1z is the first element. If you equate corresponding elements in these two matrices, then a1x plus b1y plus c1z is equal to d1 you get, a2x plus b2y plus c2z you get d2, a3x plus b3y plus c3z is equal to d3. So that's why this is the form of the matrix equation of the given equations. Okay, so generally this matrix constant, this is nothing but coefficient matrix denoted with A, variable matrix denoted with X, constant matrix denoted with B. So this is called, and this AB along with A and B, if you write that matrix is called augmented matrix. It is called augmented, A-U-G-U-M-E-N-T-E-D actually, okay. Augmented matrix. So here AB, how you write in the same matrix, first you write the coefficient matrix, and the last column you write as constant matrix. Okay, so now what we are going to discussing, this is very very important. Okay, so based on this we may get two questions in mains. So okay, now number of solutions. So these are three equations, how many many solutions they may have. Okay, see here, number of solutions we are going to discussing how to find. If R1 is rank of A, this is A matrix, R1 is rank of A. You know how to find the rank of any matrix in echelon form, just to use echelon form only. Okay, R2 is the rank of this augmented matrix. Okay, First point, if R1 is equal to R2, that is consistent. Consistent word you may listen, that means you might listen in the 10th class only. So that means consistent means they have the solutions. That means either one solution, that means unique solution, or infinitely many solutions. Okay. And if R1 is not equal to R2, then the system is called inconsistent. System means these three equations. Okay, these are the nothing but system of non-homogeneous linear equations in three variables. Now, if rank of A is equal to R1, rank of AB is equal to R2, R1 is equal to R2, this system has either unique solution or infinitely many solutions, so it is consistent. If R1 is not equal to R2, then it is inconsistent, that means it has no solution. Inconsistent means no solution. See, third point. So here we have written R1 is equal to R2. If R1 is equal to R2, okay, that value becomes to what? Which number? See, here coefficient matrix is 3 by 3. Augmented matrix is 3 by 4. So maximum rank, how much you may get? 3. Okay, so that's why if R1 is equal to R2 is equal to 3, okay, then it has unique solution. If R1 is equal to R2 is equal to 1 R2, because of after 3, what you may get? Either rank 1 or 2. So if A may be 1 or 2, both, any one if you get, and R1 is equal to R2 is equal to 1 or 2, then it has infinitely many solutions. This is the very, very important point. Now, see the one question based on this one. Check whether the system of equations x plus y plus z is equal to 6, x minus y plus z is equal to 2, 2x minus y plus 3z is equal to 9 are consistent or not. Consistent or not means what we have to find out? Either R1 is equal to R2 or R1 is not equal to R2. That one only we have to find out. Okay, that is depends upon the rank of A and rank of AB. Once we observe rank of A and rank of AB also, we can see only in this augmented matrix only. If you close this one, last column, if you close, it will be as a coefficient matrix A. If you open, if you observe the last column also, you will see it as a AB matrix. That means augmented matrix. Both we can observe in the single this AB matrix only. So that's why directly you go for this AB matrix and convert into echelon form. And after converting into echelon form, close the last column, observe the rank of A, and open the last column, observe the rank of AB. See here. Now, AB you take. AB means corresponding coefficients. That means 1, 1, 1, 1 minus 1, 1, 2 minus 1, 3. So directly you write a coefficient, that is coefficient matrix. And a constant matrix 6, 2, 9 you write. For your better convenience, if you want to draw this line, no problem. Without a drawing line also we can observe. So that is for our convenience only. So, but most of you know up to where coefficient matrix, up to where augmented matrix. Okay. Now to convert into echelon form, we have to make these two R0s by using this one. Okay. By using R1, these two elements are zeros. How to write the operation R2 implies R2 minus R1 because 1, 1 only. And R3 implies R3 minus 2 R1. Okay, by these two we have to make zero by using this one. So this is equivalent to, so first row you write as it is, second row is 1 minus 1 0, minus 1 minus 1 minus 2, 1 minus 1 0, so 2 minus 6 minus 4. Next R3 minus 2 R1, 2 minus 2 0, minus 1 minus 2 minus 3, 3 minus 2 that is 1, 9 minus 2, 6 are 12, 9 minus 12 that is minus 3. Now, which one you have to make 0? This element we have to make 0 by using this one. Okay, so R3 implies both have the same sign, keep minus here. This 2 multiply to R3 and this 3 multiply to R2. So 2 R3 minus 3 R2. Okay, this is equivalent to first row, second row, write as it is. Now, third row becomes 2. 2 into 0 minus 3 into 0, 0 only. 2 into minus 3 minus of 3 into minus 2, that becomes 2 also 0. Next 2 into 1 minus 3 into 0, that is 2 only. Next, 2 into minus 3, this number you have to substitute here, this number you have to substitute here, what you get, that is the resulting, okay, 2 into minus 3, minus 3 into minus 4, that becomes to 6, okay. Now, it is in the echelon form, here number of zeros before first non-zero number, 0, here number of zeros, first non-zero number, only 1, here number of zeros before first non-zero number, 2, so here 0, here 1, here 2, so it is echelon form only. Now close this one. What is the rank of A? 3. 3 non-zero rows are there. Open. What is rank of AB? This is nothing but AB. Okay. So, 3 non-zero rows. So, rank of A is equal to rank of B is equal to 3. Okay. Actually, he is asking to find only consistent or not. That is only he is asking. Yes, it is consistent. And if you want to say eagerly, one thing you can say, and it has unique solution, very clear, because R1 is equal to R2 is equal to 3. So the system is consistent, only our answer for this question. And furtherly, you can say it has unique solution. Objective method, same question, how to do it? Objective, how to do, very easy objective. So x plus y plus z is equal to 6, x minus y plus z is equal to 2, 2x minus y plus 3z is equal to 9. Okay. First you do one thing, you have to eliminate any one, either x variable or y variable or z variable, anyone. Okay. You have to eliminate only one variable, anyone you choose. Okay. Here a very convenient, if you eliminate this y, you can get by using 1 comma 2, if you eliminate y, then you get one equation in terms of x and z. That means if you add 1 and 2, what you get? 2x, yy get cancelled, 2z is equal to 8. So take 2 common and cancel, x plus z is equal to 4. In the second and, or 1 and 3 you can use, or 2 and 3 you can use, next one. So same y variable we have to eliminate. So if you subtract, that means 1 and 3 if you do, then you have to add. 2 and 3 if you do, you have to subtract. So 1 and 3 if you do, so same x plus 2x, 3x, yy get cancelled. So z plus 3z, 4z is equal to 9 plus 6, 15. So here, so this these are the two equations in two variables. So how to do with the two variables? Same way we have to observe. If a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, it has infinitely many solutions. If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, that is a unique solution. If a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, is not equal to c1 by c2, it has no solution. Okay, so here what you observe, so 1 by 3 is and 1 by 4 if you observe, 1 by 3 is not equal to 1 by 4, so it is consistent because of it has unique solution. System has unique solution, consistent. System has infinitely many solutions, consistent. System has no solution, inconsistent. So that is the objective. So remaining problems we will discuss in next video.